Nityananam, this is my Shivamaya. Very welcome to my YouTube channel, Completion Clicks. This is a video about highly sensitive people. And first of all, what is actually highly sensitive, being highly sensitive? What does that actually mean? Well, first of all, the information that you get in through the senses, so of course the eyes, the nose, the ears, the mouth, the touch, all of these senses let in information from the outside world, from our environment into our system. And that matters a lot to how we behave, how our body responds to that. So the amount of information that you take in through the senses, for highly sensitive people, it is more than what an average person perceives. So that means, for example, that you are noticing a lot of details, that you are noticing a lot of information when it comes to people, when it comes to certain situations, when you walk into a room, whether it's a public place or a house of someone, you immediately notice a lot more than average people do. That is basically what it means to be highly sensitive. Well, it is a term coined in psychology. Not so long ago, actually quite recently. For instance, Eileen Aron, she is a PhD and she has done a lot of research to highly sensitivity. And there are more authors actually that wrote books in the last, say, 10 years about this subject. Eileen and Aron, she estimates that there are around 15 to 20% of the people is falling in this category of highly sensitivity. So it is not mainstream, and that also means that, well, when you are not even aware that is happening, most of us are very aware actually that there is something different. But when we, as long as we don't know what is actually different, then also often we don't know how to exactly deal with it, and it can cause problems in our life. Problems with loud noises, with large amounts of people, very busy situations or places, because then the information can be perceived as an overload. A lot of high sensitive people that have in common that they feel sometimes completely overwhelmed by all what they get in. That is not at all necessary. It doesn't need to be a problem, because for every problem is a solution. And as long as you know these solutions and you feel powerful to deal with it, it is actually an extreme gift. It is a very unique quality that you can use in so many cases, in arts, artistic expressions, for example, but also in relationships, when you want to help other people. It is a beautiful asset to relate with nature. It really helps to be that sensitive. So there are a lot of situations in which you can contribute a lot when you have this gift. So you can definitely make it your strength, and I'm making more videos about how you can actually do it, what kind of beautiful techniques there are to use in order to make it your strength and to contribute from that beautiful gift and to enjoy it so much in your life, because that is also a thing that comes for highly sensitive people. You are not only aware and taking picking more information up from your environment, but you're also more sensitive to what is happening inside. And for example, when the food has extreme, like it is very, very spicy, or like things like coffee, A lot of highly sensitive people actually avoid rather those extremities because they are already very sensitive to the food. But that also means that you can deeply, deeply, deeply enjoy something. When you experience it in so many details, you can deeply enjoy arts, nature, social relationships, well, actually everything through the senses. And it also is a beautiful asset to get awakened, actually, to be more conscious of the whole inner world, not only the bodily, the material inside, hey, what happens to your organs and what happens in terms of energy inside of the body, what happens in terms of hormones and all that stuff. Also your feelings, but also your whole perception you are more sensitive to. So you can also use it as an asset to become more aware of who am I? What is going on inside? What do I value much in life? How do I cope with life? What do I want to make out of my life? A beautiful compliment that I once got from somebody I worked with was that she said, actually, I was leaving that organization. I had done some project for them and they were finished. And then she said, actually, you had a beautiful role in the team because you kept everybody all the time aware of what was going on by the questions that you continuously ask everybody and the way you are sharing and also the way you keep us aligned to where we actually want to go in terms of ethics. What role do we play actually in society and to have that discussion going on, she attributed that as a contribution to from my side. While I was actually thinking, well, for me that is so obvious. I see so many things going on in the team all the time. It's just actually from my side that I just express whatever I see. But when you are seeing so much more, or perceiving so much more what is happening in a team than what others perceive, you can contribute so much to a team. So, that was a wonderful experience and also a helpful feedback and a beautiful example of how you can use your sensitivity and make it also useful to others in a very powerful way. So stay tuned. I'm going to make more videos about this to literally help you to make it into your strength, to use it, use this unique gift that you have. Because talking to an audience, people that are also very sensitive, you know, sometimes you struggle a bit, but it is not needed. Yeah, I can give you the tips and tricks how to become very powerful and use it as your gift. The people, the world really needs people like you and me. So let's pick it up. Let's start working with it and be blissful for now. And I hope to see you in next video. Nithyananda.